Welcome to Department of Electronics and Telecommunication at Vidya Alankar Institute of Technology. In this department, we have taken this new initiative to start our own YouTube channel. In this YouTube channel, we are going to upload all our experiments video, value-added course video, or any other important videos. This material will be available to all the students in Mumbai University, and this material will help students to enhance their learning, not just in their classroom, but even outside the classroom. I hope that everyone will like this our effort, and in case of any query, comments, anything, they can put it in comment box. Thank you.
Welcome to Analog Electronics One Lab. Our today's experiment is on RC phase shift oscillator. Now, this is the circuit diagram of RC phase shift oscillator. Here, the BJT which we are using is BC547, which is in common emitter configuration. Here, this capacitor acts as a bypass capacitor. And this pair, that is a capacitor and a resistor pair, gives us a phase shift of 60 degrees. We have three such pairs, so total it gives 180 degree phase shift. We know that in common emitter configuration, BJT gives 180 degree phase shift. As a result, we get total, that is 180, and here 180, that is 360 degree phase shift. So we just get the sine wave. Moreover, this is an oscillator, so we don't have to give any input from a function generator or something, and still we get a sine wave. Here, this combination of capacitors and resistors acts like a feedback input to the base, as a result of which we get a sine wave at the output. This is all about the circuit diagram of phase shift oscillator. Now let's see its breadboard implementation. This is the breadboard implementation of RC phase shift oscillator. Here, as you can see, this is BC547, which is common emitter biased. Here, this 10K resistor is R2, and this 220K resistor is R1. As you can see, this RC is variable. Giving that, we are using a pot. This is the potentiometer which is connected. Now, for RE, we had 560 ohms. So, we didn't have that value. So, we used two 1K resistors in parallel to get 500 ohms and 156 ohms resistor. That's why our total resistance would be 556 ohms. Now, 2 microfarad is given here. And after that, we are getting output at this point. And this is the feedback resistor, feedback here. These capacitors are of 0.1 microfarad, and these two resistors are of 5.6 kilo ohms. This black wire here is used as a ground. We are giving input here and output. We are giving voltage 10 volt here, and the ground is given here. That's all for the breadboard implementation of RC phase shift oscillator. Now let's see its output. Now let's give 10 volt power supply, and now let's check the output here. We are using DSO instead of CRO. These are the probes, and now let's connect it. Let's give the output here at the capacitor. After giving the output, we can see that a sine wave is obtained. This is what happens in RC phase shift oscillator. Here, this feedback results into a sine wave. That's the oscillator. Thank you for watching.